guys, and welcome back to Nursing with Ju. And Ju is me, and I am back again with another video, okay? Okay, I haven't seen you guys since last year, so I want to go ahead and say Happy New Year. Okay, we made it. 2020 was long, it was hard, but 2021 was waiting for us at the door, okay? And guess what? I opened the door and walked right through it with open arms because, listen, 2020 was a doozy, and I'm so happy that year's over with. You know, I learned stuff, lessons, blessings, all that, but it was just too much. It was so ghetto. I'm so happy it's over, okay? Okay, all right. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I'm gonna go ahead and say that and get it out of the way with, because I know I'm not gonna remember to say it a little bit later on. So don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe so that way I can keep it with you. You can keep it with me, and we can keep up with each other, okay? Okay, today's video is going to be about what to do when it's time for you to float to a unit, okay? Now, when I was in the hospital and when I was working on a unit, I would always have to float. And we had about 3 different sister units on the unit that I was on, and we always had to float to one of them units. Now, I didn't have to float until like I was a year into my nursing career, a year on that unit, and a year of experience. And when it happened, I was just like, no, I am not ready for it. And it was like, oh no, just go ahead and go. It's gonna be all right. You're only going for a half a day, luckily. But in my mind, I'm like, oh my gosh, I'm going to a whole new unit. I don't know these people. I don't know my way around. I don't know the exact patients. I don't know how to take care of them. Like, what if I mess up? Can I just pass this float opportunity to somebody else? Can I please just do that? And she was like, no, you gotta go. It's all right. And I was just like, oh my gosh. Okay. So I took a deep breath, took everything that I needed, and was like, you know what? Let me go ahead and grab a bull by the horns and go ahead and do this. And I went there. I went in with a nice, pleasant smile, attitude, speaking to everybody, you know, just like, can you show me around? That way I know, you know, where things are, and I don't have to, you know, ask y'all during the shift. And I can just kind of like, you know, do everything on my own. And if I have questions, is it all right if I come and ask you? Or, you know, whatever, whatever. And they were like, yeah, sure. You know, this is where this is at. This is where this is at. We have 2 pictures on this side and this side. We have patients from this end of the hallway. This is the nourishment room. Da 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 this, da 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 that. And it was actually better than being on my own home unit. Right? That's crazy. And I floated so much, you know, picking up shifts and helping out where the needs were, that everybody knew me when I went to different units. They were like, hey, what's up? And I was just like, hey, what's up? It was almost like I had 3-4 home units. It really didn't bother me. And it also gave me experience with working with different type of patients, because even though I worked on a med-surg floor that specialized in orthopedics and neurosurgery, we also had sister units that were oncology, like med-tele, and a whole different other variety of patients that they catered to. And it was very helpful. It helped me develop my skills and all of that. So my advice to you when it's time for you to float to a unit is, someone, like, take a deep breath. It's gonna be okay. You got it. And nursing is nursing all around, you know. Nursing is nursing wherever you go. Now, of course, things may be different and the type of patients you cater to may be different, but you're gonna do the same thing wherever you go as a nurse. So take a deep breath, because you got it. You're gonna be able to do it. Secondly, when you get there, you know, just go ahead and introduce yourself. Let them know that you're there to help out, and you're floating there, and ask them to give you like a tour, you know, a quick tour of where everything is. That way you won't have to keep asking them and asking them to show you where this is or where to go and find this. You know, if you tell them to give you a little tour and the codes of everything, you know, when you first get there, that'll cut back on a lot of questions that you will have during the shift. That's number 2. Number 3, come in with a positive attitude, because if you come there looking like you don't want to be there, like, oh my gosh, why am I here? I don't really want to be here. Why I got to even be here? Like, why they don't got people to come and help them? If you come out the gate with an attitude like that, I promise you it's going to make the shift longer than need be. So if you come in with a positive attitude, it'll make it that much easier. Okay, they're going to want to help you, because they're going to be like, oh, she's nice, or he's nice. You know, he's here. He looks like he's willing to work. He's ready to work. And the patients don't even feel that you want to be there. If you come in with an attitude like you don't want to be there, like, I promise you, it's gonna make the shift so much longer, and it's gonna make stress unnecessary. Just go on with a positive attitude, hit the door, smile, let them know that you're here to help, like you're happy to be there. Even if you're not happy, just pretend like you're happy, okay? And I promise, your experience gonna fly by. You're gonna meet a whole bunch of friends, so the next time that you gotta float there, it's gonna be easy peasy lemon squeezy, okay? The fourth thing I would recommend at then when you get there is just asking them, like, you know, how do y'all do this? On my floor, I'm not really familiar with doing this because we don't do that too much. You know, do you mind helping me if I need to do it? You know, certain stuff like that. Just not being afraid to ask for help and just knowing where you can find your resources. You know that your charge nurse is a resource. Other nurses on the floor that have been there longer than you are, resources, and even the nurse manager is a resource for you. So just knowing where your resources are, why when you're floating, helps and cuts down on the stress as well. Okay. Fifth, when you go to the floor, just make sure that you are prepared. If you come in there, you ain't got no stethoscope, you don't got no pen light, you don't got no pen, you don't got no paper to write with. You know, it's kind of pointless because now you come there, don't have no supplies, and got to ask them for everything. You're like, well, she floated here and she unprepared. Make sure you come to the floor prepared, okay? Make sure you come there prepared. It's gonna make it a whole lot better, I promise you. I promise you, okay? I promise you it will, all right? I promise you, if you take my advice and you do those 5-6 things that I mentioned and you apply it when you go to these units and when you go in the floating and stuff like that, it will make your experience a whole lot better. It will cut back on the headache. You're going to go there and you're going to meet a whole new family. So when it's time for you to pick up and your floor don't need you, and you got to float there to get them extra coins, you're floating someplace where people know you and they love you, okay? After a while, floating can be a piece of cake. You can be like, oh, I got to go there today. Okay, that's all right. I know them. We order lunch there. I speak to them. Like, listen, when I started to float to other units, I met so many people. And we clicked just like that. That way, when I had to pick up and help them out, I already knew where things were. I already knew the people that I was working with. They already knew that I was coming to work and we were going to have a good time. And I already knew when I went there, I was going to work and have a good time. We were ordering lunch. We would even meet sometimes outside of work. And it was like I formed a whole new family on this whole different unit that I was skeptical about going to. So just take my advice. Do those things when you go to float. And I promise you, floating to another unit will not be that bad. It's going to be a break from your home unit, I promise. Okay? Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. We are going to glow and grow together. I'm going to keep up with you. You're going to keep up with me. And we're going to keep up with each other. Thank you so much for watching Nursing with Jew. I wish you a prosperous, blessed, healthy 2021. Okay? See y'all next time. Bye.